that's happening to TimkenSteel. TMST, the steelmaker that was spun off from Timken over the summer. TimkenSteel is a market-leading maker of high-quality alloy steel bars, seamless mechanical tubing, and other precision components, as well as providing value-added services like thermal treatment and machining. Now, after being spun out in July, this stock initially rallied, and it rallied very nicely. Over the last month and a half, TimkenSteel has been taken to the woodshed. Stock falling from $50 in mid-September down to $36.45 right now, including a nasty $1.72 decline in today's session. I think some of this weakness is due to worries about global economy. I've said that part of it may be caused by lightweighting, the trend where aluminum is replacing steel in a variety of applications like airplanes and automobiles. That's something I talked about in the lightning round when we got a call. It was an insightful call from Derek in California asking about the company. You see, when you call in, you just don't have my ear. You also got the attention of observant management teams like TimkenSteel. But here's the thing. When TimkenSteel reported last Thursday, the company delivered a 3-cent earnings beat off a 53-cent basis, higher than expected revenues, increased 24% year over year. Management gave solid guidance. They also initiated a 3 million share buyback. That's 6.5% of the total share count. Not too shabby. Is this TimkenSteel way of saying that they think their stock is too cheap? Let's take a closer look with Tim Timken, Chairman, President, and CEO of TimkenSteel. Mr. Timken, welcome back to Mad Money.
Good to see you again, Jim.
Thank you. Got to tell you, I thought the buyback, I thought the numbers, I thought the sell-through, meaning that you're kind of booked up till February,
right,
should have meant the stock would go higher. But, you know, you're kind of trapped in something related to oil and gas right now, related to the industrials. Kind of explain to us the mismatch here between the stock and the company.
Well, I think you're exactly right. If you look at the numbers we put out last week, they were good. A 24% rise on sales, a 50% increase on earnings, 56 cents per share, you know, a 13 cent dividend, the buyback, all very, very positive news. We also poured hot metal through our new caster for the first time in the last couple of weeks, and we announced a $40 million investment in a new heat treat facility. This is all very, very good news. Obviously, we did it in a market that is troubled by trends in oil prices.
Right.
And I think we're being dragged down by that.
And what's interesting is that you, in this call, you know, October 30, I doubt that people think change from October 31st to today, but you have a long order book,
right,
and it's not like you're seeing massive cancellations.
That's right. If you look at our order book for oil and gas right now, our lead times are out into March. People are taking the product, and our estimation is the inventories, especially down in Houston, are good. They haven't overbuilt the way they did into the last cycle. So even if we see a reduction in drilling, we think the reaction from a market point of view will be muted compared to last time around.
Well, I mean, it's also a little short-sighted. You have a very varied customer base.
We do.
Just look at it as oil and gas to me seems a mistake.
Absolutely. Well, even if you take oil and gas, we've got good distribution across onshore, offshore, vertical, horizontal. Very good broad exposure across the industry. But as a corporation, that's really only about a third of what we do.
Right.
You also have to recognize we're big into automotive and obviously very good numbers out of Detroit and the new domestics in October. We also are seeing the base industrial economy beginning to come back. Rail's been actually pretty good on the tank car build. We understand loco's going to come off a little bit next year, but they're still building tank cars, so that's all positive.
All right, now let's talk about the Klaus Kleinfeld, CEO of Alcoa, lightweighting. We had that terrific caller. There are advantages to steel that maybe aluminum doesn't have.
Sure.
I think you should enlighten us on.
Well, I'm sure there are a lot of steel companies who are worried about lightweighting and alternate product like aluminum. We're not one of those. If you look at the components that we're in, bearings, gears, crankshafts, power transmission components, you know, unless you change the laws of physics, we're not really at risk from an aluminum point of view. So we feel good in our position. We're investing in growth.
Your kind of steel is.
Our kind of
steel.
Because
you're a special kind
of
steel.
You got it. Absolutely. Highly alloyed, highly differentiated product that the applications don't lend themselves towards the use of aluminum. You know, there's a threat from dumbing down of alloys, but for the most part, we're confident in the position we're in, and we're investing in it. And we're growing very, very well with the new domestics, who are putting production here for the first time in a big way. Obviously, Mexico is growing. We see opportunity there. So we feel good about our position.
One last question, raw costs. I'm surprised they're not down more. You got a scrap component. You said the Turks, I know, because I've been to where the Turks go and buy copper.
Right.
Right here from the landfills. But they haven't plummeted yet.
Well, they're down more than we thought they would be.
Okay.
In fact, beginning of the year, we thought scrap prices would rise. Better utilization in the industry. We figured, better buy-side component to it. We have not seen that happen. Some of that is Europe being very slow. The Turks are not in the market. Strong dollar obviously has an impact in that. And we've seen a lot of ore reserves opening up, and that puts downward pressure on scrap. You know, at the end of the day, we have a surcharge mechanism that passes that across. So across the cycle, it's not a significant issue to us as we look forward. Alloys, on the other hand, we're rising. That's beginning to temper a little bit. So we're okay there.
Okay, well, I mean, I think people are misunderstanding the story. That happens. Everyone's lumping everything together, thinking that you're just one big oil rig.
Right.
And that is not the case. Anyway, that's Tim Timken, Chairman, President, and CEO of TimkenSteel. Buyback, dividend, beating the numbers, doing everything right, and yet get beaten down. Sometimes that's where the real opportunity lies. We have money's back into the break.